Hi, this is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to the next video episode dedicated to Adobe Analytics segmentation. Today we'll get to know how to build segments in Analysis Workspace of Adobe Analytics. If you have just started with Adobe Analytics, I advise you to watch my previous trainings on this YouTube channel. Now let's get started with segmentation. I will start with a project in Analysis Workspace. And my goal is to look at the site traffic for the last 30 days. I will add a freeform table, then add a metric, unique visitors, and build a trendline visualization to get an idea of a trend. There you go. So now the question is, what if I want to look not at the total traffic on my site, but I want to look only on those visitors who came from mobile devices. In this particular use case, we will need to use a segment. There are a few ways how you can build a segment in Analysis Workspace. And the very first method that I'm going to show you is you should go to the new menu and click Create Segment. A segment builder will pop up and a few words about this user interface. On the left-hand side, you can see dimension, metrics, segments, and time components that you can use in your segments. Then, the main area of this segment builder includes title, description, and here you need to enter how your segment will be named. Then, description is one of the most important parts here. Here include the description of the segment, its purpose, some use cases when it makes sense to use that segment. And let's do that. So my segment will be mobile and I will add description. This includes visits from mobile devices. And now we need to work with definition area. The very first drop-down menu that you can see here is show hit, visit, or visitor. I won't cover this in great detail in this video episode, but if you want to learn more, sign up for a free online training following the link in the description to this video. We will keep the hit option here, and now we need to build a definition for getting only those visits that were on mobile devices. I will be using the dimension that is called mobile device. This is out of the box dimension, and we'll add it to the definition area. And now if I want to include those who were on mobile devices, I will need to replace equals with exists, and this will give me all the traffic to my site from mobile devices. You can already recognize a preview showing us how many visitors, visits, and page views in percent and actually in absolute numbers as well were on our site for the last 90 days. So I will click Save and the segment will be added to segments. So let's find this segment and I will add this segment to the panel. So now we can see only those visitors who came from mobile devices. What if you want to look at your total traffic versus traffic from mobile devices? This is very easy to do. So for example, what you can do in this case is drag and drop the segment to your table and put it under the metric. This will give us unique visitors for mobile, and now I'm going to remove the segment from the panel. And if I want to compare unique visitors on mobile devices versus total traffic, I will need to add unique visitors metric to my table as a separate column. And now we can see two lines and we can compare the traffic. The next question you may ask, how we can better visualize the percentage of mobile visitors. In this case, as usual, we will add another visualization. For example, let's add the horizontal bar visualization to our project. We'll slightly resize it. And now I'm going to link this visualization to the first header row of the table. I will select this row and then we'll click on this icon and check the lock selection checkbox. Now if I uncheck the line, I will still see the visualization showing me the numbers for the header line. So now we can actually very easily compare the traffic that came from mobile devices versus total traffic. But in some cases, it's much better to compare mobile devices versus other devices. So let's call it desktop. So we can split all the traffic into two buckets, mobile and desktop. Or to be more accurate, let's call it non-mobile. So how we can do that? If you want to create a new segment, you can either create it as I showed previously by going to New, Create Segment, or you can create a segment right away in your panel. And in this case, this segment will not be added by default to your saved segments in Analysis Workspace or in Adobe Analytics. Instead, it will be saved just in this project. It will not be accessible out of this project by default. And this is in some cases a much better way since you won't flood your segments with lots of, let's say, draft segments or segments that you need only within a single project. So let's do that. I will click on the plus icon here. And again, the segment builder pops up. And I will need to now create a segment that includes mobile traffic. How I can do that? First, again, let's start with the title. This will be non-mobile. Then in description, this excludes visits from mobile devices. And I'm going to again use the same dimension, which is mobile device. But now I'm going to use another definition. In my case, this will be doesn't exist. By doing this, I can exclude mobile traffic. And as you see here, the checkbox make the segment public. If you check this box, this segment will be stored in your Adobe Analytics account. And you will be able to find this segment in any project. But if you will keep it unchecked, this segment will be available only within this Analysis Workspace project. So let's proceed and save it. And this is the segment, and I'm going to move it under unique visitors metric here. And then we'll remove it from the panel. Now we can see how many visitors came from non-mobile devices and from mobile devices. In the table, you can see the absolute numbers and percentages, but the percentages represent the share within the column. And if you want to see the share of mobile devices versus non-mobile devices, we will need to update the dimension setting by clicking on the gear icon and switching this column percentages option to the second calculate percentages by row. And now we have a much better understanding that the traffic on non-mobile devices was, for example, 45% on April 21st, and the same for other days. Now let's narrow our data set further. I want to look at this comparison, non-mobile versus mobile devices, for a specific country. And I'm going to show you the second option for building a segment very quickly. First, I need to understand which dimension or criteria I'm going to use to build a segment for a specific country. I will be using the dimension which is called countries, and this dimension contains the country names that are determined based on the IP address of your site visitors. And I'm going to look at those who came from Germany. I type in some keywords and quickly find Germany. And I'm going to just drag and drop this to the segment area under the panel. As you can see, very quickly, the segment was created automatically, and now I can see how many visitors came to my site from Germany with a breakdown by non-mobile and mobile devices. What if now I want to compare one country to another? For example, I want to compare Germany with Switzerland. First, I will drag and drop this segment to my dimension area, and then we'll remove the segment from the panel, look for Switzerland, and we'll do the same. I will move it to my segment area under the panel name, and then move it to the dimension of the table, and then we'll remove it from this again top area. So now very quickly I've got a table that contains two countries. For each country I can see traffic, and I can compare mobile versus non-mobile. And this is also very helpful when you need to build something very quickly. And as you understood, I didn't need to save the segments. I just created them on the fly with the help of automation of Analysis Workspace capability. This is probably one of the greatest features of how you can quickly slice and dice your data. Pay attention that the first visualization, line visualization, has changed, and now it's only showing Germany with a breakdown by non-mobile and mobile traffic, and it's showing us a trend line. What you can do here is if you select the segment, for example, for Switzerland, now this visualization will be showing you trend lines for Switzerland. But what if you want to compare Germany with Switzerland and also compare non-mobile versus mobile, and everything is on a single visualization, single chart? What you can do here is to deselect the rows and then update the type of the visualization. I will select horizontal bar, and very quickly now we see Germany and Switzerland and can compare non-mobile versus mobile traffic. At the same time, if for example you have many segments, for example 10 countries, and you want to filter your chart on the fly, just click on the segment here, and now we can see only mobile traffic, or vice versa. Now we can see only non-mobile traffic. So very quickly you can update your visualization. I hope that now you can better understand how to build segments. Obviously, this was just an introductory training to segmentation in Adobe Analytics, and I wanted you to get familiar with Segment Builder, with different ways of how you can build segments. And we were able to create, I think, very commonly used segments like non-mobile traffic and mobile traffic. And I also showed you how you can segment your data based on the country the visitors originated from. If you want to learn more about segmentation, sign up for an online training following the link in the description, or ask your questions in the comments. Also, if you already use Adobe Analytics, I would like to know which segments you use on a frequently basis, which ones are your favorite segments. Share that in comment. I will be happy to get your feedback, to have your questions, to have a dialogue about segmentation in Analysis Workspace. This is it for today. Thank you very much for watching this video, and see you next time. Bye.